So we'll look here at solving non-homogeneous linear ordinary differential equations, because that's what all the cool kids are doing these days. So normally in the past we've had stuff that looked like this, and that was all well and good, but now here's what happens is, like, so this is called a homogeneous, not homogeneous. We're not doing milk. Homogeneous. This is a homogeneous, I just said it, this is a homogeneous equation. If we look at something like this, this is a non-homogeneous equation, all right? Homogeneous, okay. Homogeneous, okay. That's a math lesson, not a spell lesson, but that's fine, okay. Y, dx, on the left, and on the right, I'll say 2x times 1 minus 1, like that. And this is actually separable, so it's no longer linear, but at least it's separable. It's not linear because there's that, you know, thingy. Well, I guess this is linear, but this isn't pretty on the left. I'm not just going to get a beautiful natural log. I'm going to get kind of a natural log that only your mother can love. But anyway, to do the integration on the left, I either have that one memorized, or I'm going to work it out. So with the u substitution, I'll let u equal 1 minus y. So I have du equals minus dy, or dy equals negative du. Sure, why not? Okay, so then I can do my substitution. So I've got 1 over u with a negative du on the left. And if I just want to go ahead and integrate the right, I've got x squared plus c. So I've got, I'm just going to multiply both sides by a negative sign so that I don't have to deal with that on the left. So I'll just do this. Du is equal to minus x squared plus c. And it doesn't matter if I distribute the negative because it's just a constant. And so I have natural log of u, negative x squared plus c. So I have e to the negative x squared plus c is equal to u. But u was 1 minus y. So that's 1 minus y is equal to e to the minus x squared plus c. And then what happens finally is the y goes by itself. And I've got 1 minus e to the, well, that's, this part right here is just this. So 1 minus c times e to the minus x squared, like that. Okay, so that's beautiful. And it was amazing, and I'm so happy that that happened. But really, that only happened because we got lucky. We got lucky in that it was still separable because we were able to get the x's and the y's apart. Now, if for some reason this problem had been y prime is equal to negative 2xy plus 2x squared, if I pull that 2x out, I would still have x minus y, which means it's not separable, and so I'm totally up a creek, and I can't solve this problem anymore, okay? So this is actually where variation of parameters is going to come in, okay? Is that we assume we can't always get lucky. I just wanted to solve this one for you in a case where we got lucky, so when I use variation of parameters, you actually believe me that it works. So for variation of parameters, what we're going to do is we're going to rewrite as homogeneous. And then we're going to solve it. We're going to solve the homogeneous problem, and then we're going to make a lucky guess. And it's not really going to be a lucky guess because we're going to guess the same thing every time. Make a really good guess. And then we're going to solve for u. So our guess is going to involve this function called u of x. We're going to solve for u of x, and then we're going to, you know, write the answer. Something like that. So this is basically our strategy. So we're going to rewrite the problem as homogeneous. So we're going to solve the homogeneous problem. Then we're going to make a really good guess involving that solution and another random function called u that we don't know what it is. We're going to end up solving for u, and we're going to write the answer down like it was no big deal. Okay? So I give you an example. So let's work through that same one that we already did. So last time we solved y prime plus 2xy is equal to 2x. Okay, so now we're going to write as homogeneous. So homogeneous, remember, genius. Remember means that it equals zero. Now, don't just write y prime plus 2xy equals zero. Do some kind of indication that it's a homogeneous solution. So 2xy homogeneous equals zero. Now, the nice thing about writing as homogeneous now is it's very obviously separable. So I have dy dx equal to negative 2xy. So, and again, you can solve this the shortcut way. I'm just kind of solving it the long way to chew a bear time because it's fun and stuff. All right, and I'm going to integrate. And on the left, I'll have natural log, this thing. I probably should have just done this for real. Minus x squared plus c. So the homogeneous solution is constant times e to the minus x squared, like that. Okay, so we write as homogeneous and solve. So we did that. Now what we're going to do is we're going to guess a solution. And I'm going to say, well, the homogeneous solution looks like that. I'm going to guess that the solution is y is equal to some random function u. This is a function of x. Times e to the minus x squared, because that's the homogeneous solution. You're like, well, how come this is going to work out? And if it works out for this, why do I have a whole class in this? Well, it's important to remember that when you're doing DiffyQ, that most of the time you're learning how to do, like, so there's like this many DiffyQ problems in the world, and you're like learning how to solve like this many of them, like right there. Most of them you have to solve numerically, so we're just getting these really, really super special cases that you're able to solve by hand, okay? So basically, we're going to use a skill that we've already learned, which is how to verify a solution is real. So remember that we had our original problem was y prime plus 2xy is equal to 2x. Okay. So I have this as my guess. Now tell me what y prime is. So go ahead and take the derivative of that. You're going to have to use the product rule and a little bit of a chain rule at some point. So I'm going to take the derivative of the first part times the second part plus the first part times the derivative of the second part, like that. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to plug that in to my original. So here, I'm going to plug it into there, like that. So I've got u prime, e to the minus x squared, minus 2xu, e to the minus x squared, right? Then I got plus 2xy, so there's y, and there's y, and that'll be y. So u times e to the negative x squared, and that is supposed to equal 2x. And it's going to, because I just guessed some random function. I can decide what the function's going to be later. What you're going to see right here is that this and this actually cancel out. And something that's neat about the variation of parameters method is that those are always going to cancel out. So that makes it really exciting. So I've got u prime e to the minus x squared is equal to 2x. Now I have something that's separable. I have du dx is equal to 2x e to the x squared. Okay, so remember if I divide it by a negative exponent, I can just move the negative exponent to the top. That would be okay too. So I have that du is equal to 2x e to the x squared dx. And I'm going to integrate both sides. Now, on the right, you might just look at it and go, oh, well, I know how to do that. You might not. It just kind of depends on what you can do. So I'm going to go ahead and pretend that I can't do that. So I'm going to say let u is equal to x. Well, I'm not going to use u. Let's use v. We've already got a v problem with x squared. So dv is equal to 2x dx. So on the left, I have u. And on the right, I have 2x dx, that's dv, and then I have e to the v. So the integral of e to the v is just e to the v plus c. So that's e to the x squared plus c. Remember, that's u, okay? So that was u. But remember that I had my guess was u times e to the negative x squared. So my guess was u equal, or y equals u times e to the negative x squared. So this is u times e to the negative x squared. I'm going to distribute that. So the first one's going to be 1 plus c e to the negative x squared. And I got my answer. And if you're super clever, you'll realize that's the exact same thing we got up there. So you got the same thing both sides, which is really fantastic. Now, you might be freaking out and saying, but wait, last time we did it, we got a minus sign, and this time that we did it, we got a plus sign. Does that matter? The short answer is no, it totally doesn't matter because that's a constant, right? And so if you get a negative constant or a positive constant, it's just going to change the value of c, and it's all going to come out in the wash. But just to prove it to you, I'm going to go ahead and do it. So let's pretend we had an initial, we had an initial condition of y at 0 is equal to 6. So the first time we did it, we had that y was equal to 1 minus c, e to the minus x squared. Second time we did it, we had y was equal to 1 plus c, e to the negative x squared. Okay, so if I apply my initial condition of y is equal to 0, or y at 0 is equal to 6, 1 minus c, e to the 0, so 6 is equal to 1 minus c, and that means that if I move the c over there, that's minus 5, so c is equal to negative 5, so 1 minus and negative 5, so y is equal to 1 plus 5, e to the minus x squared. Good? Now, I'll solve it the other way with my other solution. Y, it's not really another solution, that's the whole point, is y plus c, e to the 0. So 6 is equal to 1 plus c, so c is equal to 5. So that's y is equal to 1 plus 5, e to the minus x squared. So we got the same answer both ways. So even though one had a plus constant, one had a minus constant, it all still came out in the wash. So that's really neat. So variation of parameters, fantastic way to start solving some more interesting non-homogeneous ODEs.